at the pool resting.
Recording in the bathroom because the family's asleep, so I gotta be a little quiet. I'm alive, I'm kicking, I'm still dreaming, and yes, I do believe this life should be filled with dreams, right? We all, I think, in little dreams and big dreams. This was a big dream. I grew up in Buena Vista, Colorado, and so the Leadville 100, which takes place every summer, happened about 40 miles north of my house every summer, so I had heard about the Leadville 100 growing up as a kid. And folks, I had dreams of running, being a 100-miler, being able to run 100 miles basically straight. Well, I signed up for this race, the Run Rabbit Run 100, with hopes of running 100 miles, and it didn't happen. I quote-unquote failed that dream of running 100 miles, but I've learned a lot along the way, and this was my first attempt at a 100-mile race. And guess what, folks? I'll tell you about the race here in a second, but like the relief that I have mentally knowing that, I'll just say it, my body type, my body build, isn't really meant for 100 miles. And I'll get to that in a minute, but bottom line is, like, it was hard. Here's a little bit of race footage from yesterday's vlog. Go check out yesterday's vlog in the upper right-hand corner to see many more of the highs and lows of attempting to run 100 miles, attempting. And basically, it was hot. It was in the mid-80s. It didn't feel like that because we were running through trees much of the day. So it felt fairly, it didn't feel too hot, but it was. It was deceptive. It was deceptively hot. And when I took my shirt off at the end of the race, when I stopped and my vest off, they were just like almost, there was white streaks everywhere, like really a lot more than usual, which means I was sweating out all my salt and sodium. And so I think I may have lost too much sodium. And folks, I'm a rookie to this distance. A couple people from mile 25, when I almost blacked out at 25, a couple people stopped me and said, "Hey, you don't look great. Are you okay? Like, have you been taking salt tablets?" No, I have not been taking salt tablets. What are those? Like, I have heard of salt tablets, but I've never used salt tablets. I guess it's a big thing in 100-mile races. I probably should have known that, especially in a hot condition. Oh, I mean, it's like a little bit of a rookie mistake, but that's okay. But you literally eat salt tablets to re-energize your body so you can absorb water and nutrition. Anyway, so that was the first mistake. And then about mile 28, my plantar fasciitis flared up pretty bad. In my left foot, like it hurt pretty bad. There's just no other way to say it. And so the combination of losing too much salt, my plantar flaring up, I was proud of myself though. Like I stuck my nose in it for about 21 miles, 22 miles. And, from mile like 32 to 38, I felt okay. But then everything went downhill from 38 to 48. And I basically had to walk and hobble the last like 6 miles to get to Joseph and Mackenzie, my crew, part of my crew. And even though I did not have a great race, I did have the best crew in the world, no doubt about it. They were cheering, my grandmother was here, aunts, nieces, nephews. It was amazing. Like the cheering section was amazing. So I love you guys and thanks for coming out to support. But the bottom line is this is ultra running is a huge learning curve, and I'm not saying I'm done with 100 miles forever, but honestly, if I don't attempt another one until I'm 43, so in 10 years from now, I'm okay with that, because guess what? The guys winning these races, they're in their 40s. The third place guy, 47 years old, 47. So it's like it takes years of experience, years of getting stronger in your legs. It's crazy. Like, I'm telling you guys, like my legs are strong, but they're kind of small when you look at all the other runners out there. So I'm excited for the Pikes Peak Ascent next year, and like the 13 mile to 32 mile distance is my sweet spot. I'm gonna stick there in 2019. I'm not gonna try 50 milers or definitely not 100 milers or 100 Ks. Like, I know my sweet spot and I know what I'm good at now. And it took an entire season of ultra racing to figure that out. But I feel so confident now in like focusing in on 50 Ks, 25 milers, 13, you know, the Pikes Peak Ascent, 13 miles up a 14er, like that is my sweet spot for sure. So even though the results of Run Rabbit Run was not what I was hoping for at all, it opens up a lot of relief for the future to know what I should focus on for 2019. So, and FKT attempts up 14ers, all that good stuff. Whew, okay. I'm gonna stop there. I love you guys. We had a great day at the pool, recovering, and I am alive. I can walk. It's gonna hurt more tomorrow because DOMS, delayed onset muscle soreness, but that's how it goes, right? So thank you again for the support. You guys are amazing. It's hard, but we keep fighting together, right? And just keeping, you know, you set your dream. You dream, you fail, you dream, you fail, you dream, ooh. You rise up. Maybe you hit. You're not going to hit every goal in this world. You are not. But if you keep fighting, you will eventually hit goals. Not every goal, but you will hit some goals, no matter how small or how big they might be. And of course, it takes patience. Seek beauty. Work hard. Love each other. See you tomorrow. I was in the shower recording.